So how do you specify a trapped key system? First, choose a gate set for the number of gates you need to control. There are currently 5 options to control 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5 gate systems. And do you want that with regular contacts or with solenoid control? Step 2, select the type of actuator tongue keys that you'll need. They don't all have to be the same. Step 3, select any optional modules you'll need, the padlock or safety key modules, a key module set, or even just an additional gate actuator. If you want to save yourself some time and effort, get this optional mounting plate. It's pre-drilled and tapped specifically for these modules. You just screw the modules on it and then mount the assembly to your system. And the best part of the mounting plate is, the mounting plates come with all the screws you need and they're exactly the right length to bolt the modules to the plate. If you don't get the mounting plate, then keep in mind the gate key sets only come with 2 tamper-proof screws per station. This is just a convenience for you, so you don't have to go out and find these special tamper-proof screws yourself. You will need to provide the rest of the screws. Again, mounting plates come with all the screws you need. Gate key sets only come with 2 tamper-proof screws per station. If you plan to use the tamper-proof screws, make sure you have one of these special T20 Torx screwdrivers. You can get those at AutomationDirect.com. Speaking of screws, these M4 screws can be a little tricky to get started since you'll be threading them blind through a module in an oversized hole. That means if you're not careful, you can easily cross-thread these guys. And if you keep screwing after they've been cross-threaded, they really get locked in tight. They'll break off in the hole before they come out. They're really stubborn. So be really careful when threading these screws in. Do it by hand screwdriver. Don't use a power screwdriver. And if you feel any resistance at all, stop. These should go in real easy. If they don't, something's wrong. Don't force it. Here's a trick I use that seems to work every time. I put the screw in, apply a little pressure with the hand screwdriver, and then turn the screw backwards until I feel the click of the threads dropping into place. Now I know the threads are lined up and the screw goes in easy. Try it. Hopefully it'll work for you too. Note that there's extra room at one end of the mounting plate to accommodate the extra length of the contact and solenoid modules. And while the contact module takes up just one position on the mounting plate, the solenoid module takes 3. So don't forget to add that extra length when you're ordering mounting plates, if you're using a solenoid module. Assembling the modules is easy. Just place the locking ring on top, rotate it 45 degrees, drop the next module on top of that, and rotate the locking ring back. Done. Now keep in mind, both modules have to be in the same state or these little interlocking fingers won't line up. For example, to stack 2 of these 0-1 key modules, they both need to have keys in for them to mate or both need to have keys out for them to mate. If you're coupling a gate actuator module and one of these 1-0 key modules, then if the key is in, the gate latch needs to be out. Again, both modules need to be in the same state for those interlocking fingers to line up. When you buy a key module set, the keys associated with the modules in that set are unique. So if you order a 2-gate set, and then 5 minutes later decide you really needed 4 gates, so you order another 2-gate set, the keys won't be interchangeable. Every key set you order has a unique serial number, so make sure you order what you need the first time. That's really important because it guarantees that one system's keys can't open another system's gates, which maintains the integrity of your safety system. And for the same reason, you can't buy spare keys. If you could purchase spare keys, which you can't, someone could use that spare key to restart the system while you're still working on it, again, jeopardizing the integrity of your safety system. The best way to visualize a trapped key system is to draw up a key transfer plan. There's lots of examples like these in the catalog pages. This one shows a standard 2-gate system. This one below it is showing another use for the padlock module. In this example, pulling the padlock module key deactivates the contacts and releases the keys so folks can go work on other parts of the machine. This one diagrams the key transfer station we talked about earlier. It shows how adding this 1001 key module pair allows you to remote the release of the main station keys. This one shows you how you can use an extra actuator at the main station. In this case, opening a door would deactivate the contacts and release the keys above it. If you had a solenoid module here, then you wouldn't be able to open a door until the solenoid releases it. So get in the habit of drawing up a key transfer diagram like these. They make it much easier to map out exactly what you need. The slider tongue is spring-loaded in the disengaged position. So when a gate door closes behind you, you can't accidentally get locked in. Someone has to consciously push this slider in. Avoid using this kind of tongue on a sliding door. Remember, the actuator module won't accept the tongue while you have the key above it pulled. These things are tough, but if someone decides they're going to try and slam a big heavy sliding door into the actuator, something's going to give. Probably this tongue actuator. You're much better off using one of these sliding tongues that gets inserted after the door is closed. There's also a spring-loaded tongue that's more forgiving than the regular tongue. In addition to the red solenoid LED, there's also a yellow and a green LED on the solenoid base that you can wire however you want. The non-solenoid contact base has a red and green LED for you to use however you want. Well, that ought to be enough to get you up and running with Trapped Keys from Automation Direct. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning tech support during regular business hours. They are here to help you.